Let's go back to the menu administrative interface. I'm going to go to structure and then menus and list links in the user menu. And here in Drupal 8, I'll click edit, edit menu, and here's our piece of content. In Drupal 7, there are many components that display as a list. For example, menu items, content, comments, and so on. And one of the conventions was to have an operations section to the right of the details. In most cases, there would just be a couple of options. In this case, there's edit and delete. But in others, there are 4 or 5, and that makes the operations section pretty wide, blocking out the ability to read other content in the table. And it also makes it likely that you'll click the wrong operation. In Drupal 8, both of these problems were solved by using a drop-down button. So when there's more than one option in the operations, there's a drop-down button, and you can select between the different items there. So this compresses the operations into a single item. It makes it less likely that you'll click on an operation that you didn't intend. And finally, it streamlines the path toward the most common operation. In this case, we'll want to edit our menu items more often than we'll want to delete them. And so the edit operation gets the front and center position. In this case, we want to delete our item. So I'm going to click delete and then delete again. And then in Drupal 7, let's do the same thing. Delete and then confirm.